All right, what's going on, people? Hope everybody's having a freaking great evening. Hope y'all are popping up your nice cold coronas or your, what are those new things, quarantinis, all right? Hope everybody's having a great time, hopefully staying inside, hopefully nice and safe. Welcome to the At Wit's End podcast, okay? It's a show that's 100% live, 100% interactive, okay? So what that means is if you guys are commenting in the chat right here, we read your chat. We talk back and forth, okay? This ain't a show where you just sit back and watch. You are just as much a part of the show as we are. Now, before we get started, I got a couple things to say. First and foremost, thank you everybody who has followed the show. We are like this close to reaching our goal. We're at 92 followers. We're trying to reach 100 by the end of the month. So if you haven't, go on to our profile, hit that follow button, all right? Help us reach our goal. Also, if you like or share this stream, you guys get your own shout out. What's up? It pops up right here, and we'll also say what's up and thank you for what you guys do. You guys are freaking awesome, man. Yeah. Those of you who have been here for a hot minute, you know that we just changed our goal meter from up here, which was our follower goal meter, to down over here, which is now our fundraiser meter, okay? So what we're doing something a little bit different. We're doing something for someone who's near and dear to Julian's family. I'm going to let him talk about that for a little bit. So go ahead, Julian. What is it all about?
Yeah, most definitely, man. So my future brother-in-law, his sister, she's a 22-year-old mother of one. She's recently diagnosed with stage 4 non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. And right now she's currently stable. She's in the hospital. She's doing great. We're trying to just raise whatever funds and money that we can that go towards like medical bills and things of that nature, right? And just helping out whenever we can. So if you guys have like a dollar, 10 cents, whatever, it does not matter. Anything you can do to help support, any money that we make during this live stream is going to go directly to that. And we'll also link in the chat and as well in the description, if you guys want to go donate towards directly to them. You guys are more than welcome to do that too. Anything's appreciated. Just really wanted to get the word out there and, you know, just trying to be helpful and lend a hand.
For sure. So like, thank you guys. Like we never ask for money. Like that's not our stick here, but for something like this, why not? So the link to donate is in the description as well as we'll link it up in the chat as well. So that way you guys, anything, 10 cents, a dollar. I know times are hard right now. And especially for Miss Annabelle, you can imagine what they're going through. So anything you guys can help with, we really appreciate that. But the main form of currency here is likes and shares. So we always appreciate that. All right. So we do have a freaking cool show for y'all today. All right. We got a lot of new things, if you notice. All right. We got a new freaking sweet setup here. Thanks to Julian, who built this cool logo over here and minor little tweaks and little changes that we've done here.
We're now getting fancy.
We're getting fancy. All right, so we also got another change, all right, and this is something we're really excited about. We got a new segment of this show called Mad News Minute. Shall we get started, Julian?
Let's jump into it.
Let's get this freaking started. Before we do, thank you, Ezekiel, for the like. I appreciate it. All right, let's get this started. All right. Good evening. We have some breaking news this evening, and all across the United States, a lot of stores and restaurants have been closing to help slow the rapid infection of the coronavirus. But going against the grain, GameStop has refused to close all of their stores. And in fact, they've actually labeled themselves an essential business. And you know how valuable that title is, essential, right? So they labeled themselves an essential business, rumor going around. GameStop CEO has actually said nothing will get in his way for giving you 10 cents for that $60 game. Over to you.
In related news, the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Gordon Ramsay, has took it upon himself to perfect the hand washing method in order to prevent further spread of coronavirus. Not only did he prevent the scrambled eggs, he took it upon himself to perfect hand washing. He's not the hero we need, but he's the hero we deserve. Back to you, Wilson.
Absolutely impressive. hats off to that man. We do not deserve him. All right. Over to other news. Former presidential candidate, now diva pop star, Sarah Palin was unmasked in the hit show The Masked Singer, where she sang a touching and beautiful heartfelt song in which I will read one of the lines from that song. Following lyric goes, "I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny when a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist and a round thing in your face. Well, you get sprung. And if that's not beautiful, I don't know what is." Over to you, Julian.
For music-related news, Travis Barker and Machine Gun Kelly have taken it upon themselves to reimagine Paramore's hit single, Misery Business. Let's go to the clip. Take a little listen. I'm in the business of misery. Let's take it from the top. She's got a body like an hourglass. It's ticking like a clock. It's a matter of time before we all run out. Just when I thought she was mine, he caught her by the mouth. I waited 8 long months. He finally set her free. I told her I couldn't lie. She was the only one for me. 2 weeks when we caught on fire. He's got it out for me. But I wear the biggest smile.
Wow, that was amazing, all right? And that was your Mad News Minute. See you next week. All right. That was freaking cool. All right, so a bunch of news, a little funny stuff that we like to talk about. None of that news is important, I promise you, but something we thought we'd add to the show. Now, the tie. Yeah, the tie is that made the whole piece, the tie, okay? So anyways, where was I? Ah, yes, now. We have a freaking cool show for you today. We're talking about shows that were essential to our youth, all right? When we were young, all the shows that we were talking about. And I mentioned what the show was going to be to my, you know, my mother. She's my publicist, so I always talk to her about stuff. And she was like, oh, yeah, like Bill Cosby and, Family Matters. And I'm like, okay, Boomer. Hey, slow it down there. talking about this generation show, all right? No, but we're talking about shows that Julian and I watched as kids and that we thought were cool. If you guys have different shows that you grew up on or like the things that you keep up with or the things that, you know, made you who you are, put it in the chat. We'll talk about those too, all right? I'm going to lead it off. I'm going to lead it off with a show that I remember fondly, which is a freaking sweet show called Doug. You remember that show, Doug?
I love Doug.
Doug is a freaking sweet show. All right, let's watch the intro because this song, by far, is like the best intro song that anybody could ever make.
Oh, this song slaps.
All right, so like if you've never seen the show Doug, it's an awesome classic from back in the day. Follows this character named Doug. He has his love interest Patty Mayonnaise. All right, there's a bully. Yep. He's got a best friend Skeeter. Like it's just your typical young kid story, right? There's a couple of things that I didn't know. Is one, the character Doug is based on the creator's actually life story, right? Jim Jenkins. Okay, he wrote this based on his life. All right, now
crazy.
And which one of the things that freaking broke my heart was the fact that, you know, at the end of the series, if you've ever followed it all the way to the end, the series finale ends with him and Patty Mayonnaise never getting together, right? You know, like the love interest is always there, and you think he's gonna get it. Yeah. He didn't, and it freaking that sucks, right? Yeah. So what ended up happening is they just ended the series, and years later they asked him like, hey man, I know you never wrote it into the script, but do they fall in love or what? And he's like, no, they don't, right? He actually had like a high school crush. Her name wasn't Patty Mayonnaise, but it was based on somebody real. And years later, when she found out that the character was based on her, she reached out to him. She wanted to give him thanks. You know, hey, thanks for, you know, memorizing me in that kind of light. So they met up, and he was excited. He was like, oh man, maybe I get to rekindle this love. One of the first things she tells him, and it broke my heart, was, I would like for you to meet my husband.
Dang, dude.
Dang. He was just like, dude. Oh, so because of that, Doug forever will be in my heart. Yeah, it's a freaking sad story, right? But dude, that's real life. Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That crushes me, man.
You got friend zoned forever, right?
I can't believe that was real. Like, I never thought that Doug would be like real. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So Doug's character, his name is not Doug, but Doug's character, which you and I have a close friend. Doug's character was supposed to be, his name was supposed to be Brian.
Oh, no way.
And it was supposed to be that because that character was supposed to be as, like, normie as possible. Like, you know, everybody in the show has different color skin. Skeeter's got green skin. He's just, like, the normal plain Jane dude. So he was like, you know what? I should name this guy Brian because that's a normalist name. But the producers were like, do something a little different. So he went with Doug. But that made me think of our friend Brian. Like, that's a normie name, but. Hey guys, those of you that just like the stream, thank you guys for the like. I saw Hector in there. Did you catch that other name? And Eddie, thank you so much for the likes, guys.
Yeah, thank you so much, guys. What I was noticing, I don't know if you noticed or if you knew this, but the guy who voiced Roger in Doug also voices Fry in Futurama.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Like, that guy does so many voices. Yeah. It's mind-blowing.
Like SpongeBob's voice does.
Yeah, just like that guy.
Hey, Jeff, dude. Thanks for the like. All right, man. So, that was mine. I love Doug. I can still watch it to this day. And now that I know a little bit more facts, I think I'm going to rewatch the whole series. So, quarantine binge? I think yes, right?
Hey, I have a quick question. Yeah. Now that Disney always had like a piece of Doug, right? But they had like the remake Doug or like the reboot Doug?
So, up until 1995. So, they did 5 series, seasons with Doug under Nickelodeon. On the 5th season, they decided because they were doing budget cuts that they were just going to nix Doug. So Disney came around, you know how Disney does, and scooped him up. And that's where we got the Doug movie. We got Doug little character figures and all this and that. So Disney ended up picking him up afterwards, and now Disney owns the sole rights to Doug. And that's Nickelodeon's fault. That's their loss.
Hey, man. You got to do what you got to do.
Where you at? It better be on Disney Plus. I got to go find it.
Sabrina says it is on Disney Plus.
Disney Plus, yeah, we're gonna do a quarantine binge.
Well, right. Speaking of Disney Plus, while we're still on this topic, right?
Yeah.
Another show that was near and dear to my heart growing up was Gargoyles.
Gargoyles.
And that show is on Disney Plus, so you can watch the whole freaking thing. And I recently discovered this, right? I didn't know this existed. Uh-huh. Or if this was real or not. But now that I know that it is on Disney Plus, I'm definitely going to rewatch because here's a fact for you, okay? Okay. You know the main gargoyle Goliath, right? The leader, the boss, right? And there was Elisa, the cop, she was like a cop and the gargoyles were on top of her police station or whatever. Apparently, they fell in love, they shared a kiss, and they adopted some form of child.
Well,
they adopted a baby. That relationship's not going to work with a real baby. You know what I mean?
They don't, mix. Like, okay.
It doesn't. But like, what the heck?
There was a love interest in that season?
Yeah, apparently, dude.
Series? No way.
Apparently, there was a love interest, and that's how it ended, was with them kissing and eventually adopting a child.
So you're telling me that a gargoyle has better luck than Doug does?
Hey, man.
It's because of the muscles, you know?
It's because the muscles, the loincloth, and the belt.
Oh, yeah. Loincloths get them all. Loincloths where it's at.
That's where it's at.
So I never really watched Gargoyles, to be honest. Like, just
really?
Like, I don't know. It never appealed to me. I don't know why. Dude. They made a little gargoyle family. Yeah. They were half human winged little demon beasts.
Dude, that's got to be weird for the kid, because the kid can only see his dad at night, right? Yeah. Otherwise, he's like stone.
That sucks. That's a crappy dad story right there. He only has visitation at night.
Yeah,
just at night. That's so sad. All right, so Gargoyles. Anybody like Gargoyles? Who will? I didn't really watch it. All right, drop a like if you guys like Gargoyles. It just wasn't for me. How many seasons did they go, do you know?
They went four seasons. And then they had a comic book series after that.
Yeah, I knew they were big on comic books. I knew that was like not their main shtick, but that's where I got to know them.
Dude, I had a freaking gargoyle action figure. The flapping out wings.
Yeah.
It was
Dragon
dope.
Ball Z is another crappy dad story. Yeah, he keeps dying. Like, and then yeah. So Dragon Ball Z, I love Dragon Ball Z. I love it. But I think I was a little older when I started watching DBZ, you know. Cool, man. So Dragon Ball Z. All right, my turn.
Yeah, your turn. Go for it. What you got?
All right. I have one of the best series that shapes a young man or a young woman, but I think this is a young man story, into being an adult, right? And that's Boy Meets Freaking World, man. And the moment I knew I was a man was when I saw Topanga, if you know what I mean. I was of age. I was young back then too. Okay, and now it's a little. Well, she's grown up with me. All right, but Topanga, I had eyes for Topanga. but it was a cool story, right? It was these two best friends, and it was funny, and it had a family atmosphere, and it was a good show. But I think that's still my crush to this day. Like, cause that was since I was young, man. It's like a high school crush.
Dude, I mean, I agree.
Did you have the hots for Topanga?
I did have the hots for Topanga.
Oh, yeah.
For being just straight up.
At the elementary school hots for her.
You know what? I was talking about this show with my wife earlier today.
Uh-huh.
And she said, she compared this to, like, the How I Met Your Mother for our younger generation. Like, if we, like, growing up, like, this was, like, our How I Met Your Mother. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
if you think about,
I mean, kids don't watch How I Met Your Mother. Is that what you mean?
Well, no, but like, if there was a show for us at that age, like if there was a How I Met Your Mother for us at that age,
yeah,
it would definitely be this show. Yeah, sure. Because they went all the way up until college, right?
And they would be How I Met Your Mother characters.
Yeah, dude,
it just definitely all grew up and it just turned to How I Met Your Mother.
Yeah.
Fina. Yeah, that was funny. They had so many iconic characters, man. Like, their story grew, and then, like, someone would get into, like, you know, it was a real story. It's not like, what is one of the shows that kids watch now? Like, iCarly or something like that? Like, I don't know what they
iCarly's over.
Is it? She got pregnant or something. I don't remember.
Did she? I don't think that's right.
I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. You want to search that?
I don't think that's right. I don't think that's accurate. I think she just moved on with her life.
Anybody in the chat? Anybody know if iCarly got pregnant?
I don't think iCarly got pregnant.
Oh, and maybe Plot I'm twist. Thinking about the other one.
Other one? Oh, Zoe 101?
Zoe 101. That's
dude,
the one.
Dude, yeah,
I'm
she did get pregnant. That, yeah. That's real.
See, I'm not
that's
crazy. Real. Hey, Christina, thanks for the like. Hey, let's do a recap. Those of you that just liked the stream, if you notice, we don't have our follower goal. Even though we're getting close to it, we're at 92. We need 100. If you haven't hit the follow, hit that follow. And if you do notice down below, we have a donation fundraiser. So Miss Annabelle is a family, is soon to join Julian's family pretty soon. She's just being diagnosed with lymphoma, and we're doing a nice fundraiser. Nothing big. We're trying to raise $20, anything if you have 10 cents. The link is in the description of this video. And as well, we'll drop it in the chat towards the end of the video. Anything that you can donate to. Eddie, thanks for the share, man. You get a twerk video if you join our Discord. Look at that. Heck yeah. It's me twerking, so.
You know, people are going to come asking for the twerking videos. And
hey, where's his name that came last? He never joined the Discord. I have it.
Oh, VJ?
VJ, I made the video. It's sitting in my inbox right now. It's
just waiting to be
just
sent.
Just waiting for a hacker to come and be like, what the hell is this? All right, but on to the next show, man. What was your next one that you really enjoyed as a kid?
The next show for me was Power Rangers. How could it not be Power Rangers? You know what I'm saying, dude? Power Rangers was the best show ever. Oh, yeah. It was like, it was Morphin Time every time. You know what I mean? It's just like when pizza's on a bagel, you can have pizza anytime.
Yeah.
It's the same thing as Morphin Time. It's the exact same thing.
So Power Rangers, I do like it. I do enjoy Power Rangers a lot. The only thing, like, being an adult now and looking back at it, like, it was corny. It's just dubbed over Chinese some Asian, like, video, and we just overdub it with our mouths and then add our scenes of our, you know, regular old characters going to high school and whatnot. But, like, does it not bother anybody, like, that Asian descent woman was the Yellow Ranger, the black guy was the Black Ranger, Old Billy Bob was a Red Ranger. Like,
hey man, look, all I'm saying is this show, right, from the East, it was 100% just the people from the East playing these characters. So there was no, like, and on top of that, the Yellow Ranger in some of the series, I was looking up, like, facts about this show, right?
Okay.
The Yellow Ranger on some of the series, if you watch the series again, the Yellow Ranger is not wearing a skirt because in the other version, the Super Sentai version is what it's called, the Yellow Ranger was a man and not a woman until they came over here to the States.
Ah, okay. So the old dubs, they just swapped it out with a female.
Yeah.
Who just so happened to be Asian. I don't know.
And hey, other fact, do you know that the guy who played the Black Ranger, the OG Black Ranger, didn't have a finger. He didn't have a middle finger.
No way.
Yeah, if you look at it in his morphing time, he only has three fingers on the morpher.
All right,
I also didn't know that. These are all just like facts that I'm so excited to share with everybody.
One, look at his fingers. One, two,
he had three. No. Okay, when he had the gloves on and stuff like that, he had fingers. He had all five fingers.
This is his hand. You see it?
Look, let's watch the morphing time. Three. Did you see that?
One, two, three, and then I did not know. This whole freaking time he was missing a finger.
He's missing a finger. Legit. Pause it. Pause it on his morph. He has three finger power. Look, one, two, three. Three fingers.
Oh, Lord. I did not know that. That's a cool fact.
Boom.
Everybody's got four and a thumb, and the homie's got three. That's
pretty and crazy. A thumb.
Power Rangers was cool. Everybody had Power Rangers. We all wanted to grow and fight the giant thing. And even though it was like repetitive, like it would fight the bad guy would get big, they would get in their robot thing, and they would fight and they would win. And we'd be like, bro, I can't wait to the next episode. Like, that was fire. That was fire.
the only other thing is when they did the casting call for the show, they were looking for obviously teenagers with attitude, right?
Yeah.
But they were also looking for people with martial arts backgrounds because the majority of the bulky fight scenes in the suits, they also had like they did the suit stuff stunts too, right?
Okay.
But the majority of like the bigger stunt scenes, they just took the footage from the Super Sentai version and brought it over here. And what they did to make it more appealing or just make it new and fresh is they added fight scenes with them outside of the suits.
Yeah.
So that's how they went around and did that stuff.
Superimposed. Isn't that like copyright infringement or something? Anyways.
Nah, dude, because it's the same guy. He sold the rights over here. He took 7 years. Another fact, he took 7 years to get this show produced.
Wow. And it became a hit. So that's
a hit.
That's dedication. Hopefully we don't take 7 years to get to that level. But
if we do, I'll be there. We did it.
So the Power Rangers have had like a bunch of different adaptations from them. Like there's Ninja Rangers and like Monk Rangers now. And I don't know. There's all kinds of cool stuff. Raptor Rangers.
Raptor Rangers.
But the OG will always be. That's where it's at. The OG Rangers. All right. Where are they at now? Like what kind of Rangers do they have?
They have Super Time Force.
Like, who's that girl?
That's the Ranger Zeo, I think, or whatever. Space Rangers.
Helmets look dumb now. It's like a.
That's not even that one was still around when we were kids. Like when we were growing up, they were still doing that specific show.
OG
I think it
only.
Was Neo or Zeo or something like that.
Ah, OG Rangers. OG Rangers. All right, where are we at on the comments? So ALF was a good show. Never watched ALF. I think that's,
I never watched ALF.
I think that's boomer generation. I'm sorry to say that, but
did you know the ending of ALF?
Does he die? I don't know.
No. So apparently, like I looked this up, or I had seen some videos about like how shows ended, and they were just weird. But the ALF ended up getting the CIA was trying to get to ALF, right? And then they ended up they were like, hey, if ALF doesn't come with us, because he's living with the family, like if ALF doesn't come with us, like they were gonna do some shit. And they ended up faking ALF's parents contacting him or whatever, and he went to go meet up with his parents and leave the family that he was living with and his good life or whatever, and the CIA gets him and
oh snap
and I guess they were gonna autopsy him or something or cut him open. Ugh. So I don't think it ended too good for Alf, man.
Sorry, Alf. That's not cool at all. Damn, that's not a kid show. What are you watching that for? Hey, Alexander, thanks for the like. And also, we had a follow. I missed that one, but thank you so much for the follow. If you see who that follow was, give them that shout out that they deserve. Now, Christina, Generation X. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to call you Boomer. I'm sorry. Time Force was the best story wise of the Power Rangers series. Yeah.
I don't remember it, but I've been wanting to get into the new comic book series.
Mm-hmm.
It's like an alternate timeline. So the Green Ranger stayed evil, and yeah, then he kept that power and it started corrupting him. He killed the Tommy of the show that we watched.
Uh-huh.
And now he took over the whole Ranger Force, started killing Power Rangers.
Didn't one of the Rangers do like rated X movies?
I don't know if that's true or not, but if it is, I think it was the Red Ranger, right? Is
yeah.
that what I heard?
Oh yeah, it would yeah. be the Red Ranger. Old Billy Bob's gotta get in somewhere, you know? All right. Hey, Arnold. Yeah, Felipe. Hey, Arnold was freaking awesome, too. And I was stuck between whether to talk about Doug or Hey, Arnold. Mm-hmm. I just went with Doug because it was more OG to me. Hey, Arnold was an awesome show. It was kind of the reverse where instead of Doug in love with Patty Mayonnaise, it was, I forget the girl's name who was in love with Arnold.
Helga.
Helga. Beautiful
Helga
name.
Helga Pataki.
Helga. Beautiful name. All right,
Come
so I'm going
to
move
Bob's
over.
Beeper Emporium.
I'm going to move over to a show that I probably shouldn't have watched as a kid, and that is Ren and Stimpy.
Hello, boys and girls.
So, was like, that show that bad?
I don't think this is what a young child who is, his mentality is being groomed and learning yeah. stuff and just uh-huh. trying to become himself should watch. A crazed chihuahua, and I don't know what the other thing is, a cat?
I think he's a cat, yeah.
Who love to rub each other's butts. Happy, happy, joy, joy.
I remember that song. Still lives with me to this day.
It was just an idiotic show. Like, this had no value to it whatsoever.
Do you remember the toast guy? The toast superhero with the toast head? And then he would, like, he would squeeze them out of his butt cheeks or something like that.
There was this weird fascination with that show and butts. And just probably where I got it from. I'm a butts guy, so I'm sorry. So thinking back on my development, I now see where all these things come from. But yeah, that show, I don't know why it ran for so long. I don't know why it was available to children on a children's network.
Yeah.
But golly, I love that show. It was freaking
They brought it back, right? I think I saw that show on Spike TV at one point, like back in like 2000 something.
I think they still do like reruns of that and stuff. So yeah. Cow and Chicken was a screwed up show. Yeah, Cow and Chicken
too.
Dude,
I freaking loved Cow and Chicken. That show was scene. The best.
Yeah, for a while I thought that scene was like the log scene where he's cutting the log on his back, on the cat's back. I thought it was like Doctor, like someone just remade it, kind of like that that Mickey Mouse scene where he's like putting holes in the cheese, because that's not real. They just put something, they redid it. Anyways, that's a real scene.
I don't think I've ever seen that scene.
Let's see how, it came out on TV for a kid's show, so log song, I think is what
so
it's called.
So while you're doing that, Felipe down here in chat says Dexter's Lab.
Dexter's Laboratory, for sure.
Yeah, yeah. Dude, okay, me and my wife were watching Dexter's Lab recently, you know, quarantine style. And we were watching Dexter's Lab, and then it was an episode where Dee Dee, his sister, had an imaginary friend. I forgot his freaking name. But he was describing how she had another imaginary friend and his creation. Yeah. Dude, straight up, it was a sperm. It was a little spermy. And then there was an egg. Boom, made his imaginary friend. I'm like, what the heck, dude?
And I didn't need to have that talk with my parents after that. So now I know.
That's how you make imaginary friends.
All right, maybe I'm wrong. I don't think that scene is actually from Ren and Stimpy. Chat,
the
correct me
scene?
If I'm... Yeah, correct me if I'm wrong, and I'm, as a matter of fact, I'm not going to show it because I don't think it's from Ren and Stimpy. I think someone remade this. I will show still. Here, as you can imagine, is Ren with his saw. And I'm not going to show that. Well, you can see from the mini thing what happens here. That's about all I'm going to show here. Just, we're going to keep it rated G here. You know, we want you to have fun with your family and your kids. All right? Felipe says it is, that it's a legit portion of the show. I'm just gonna stay on the side of caution and not show that. But if you have it, okay. Google That's or wise. YouTube Ren and Stimpy log cutting, and you will you'll see exactly what the hell I'm talking about. But yeah, that show is inappropriate on all fronts. All right, Julian, what's the next show that kind of caught your eye as a kid?
So for me, man, I had to go do it. I had to do it to him, right? The OG, the meme lord himself, SpongeBob SquarePants.
Oh, yeah.
SpongeBob. How could you not?
SpongeBob did such a good job of, like, having things that will, even like today, if I told the chat, Mahoy Manoy. You know, like, most of you know what I'm talking about. Doodle Bob, right? If I say anything about Doodle Bob, the memes are like, oh my god, like, galore. My phone. Okay. Hey, Google is listening to me. I shed it again. Dang it. Don't say H Google. All right. Log cutting scene was real, but it was for Spike TV version. That's where we saw it from. Okay. Yeah. But SpongeBob did such a good job. Like, the Texas song, I Wanna Go.
Oh, ooh, yeah.
Like, those, like, how did they stick with us for so long?
I don't know, dude. But he still is like 4 hours later.
Yeah, and that is still a meme. Like, that is still funny to this day.
Yeah,
that is
still a meme. I don't. So much later that the narrator, they had to get tired and they had to hire a new one. But there's so many things that are still relevant to this day that people are incorporating into their everyday life.
Yeah, what are some of your favorite SpongeBob memes? What are the quotes that are relevant to this day? Like the jellyfish dance party.
Oh yeah.
It's like iconic, man. Like you can't leave SpongeBob alone, and it'll keep coming back for generations to come. Felipe, SpongeBob as an adult show. So I heard that rumor too, and I think maybe we should do a deep dive on that. You want to do a deep dive?
Let's do a deep dive. Because that show came out in what, like 2000? Around 2000?
I don't know.
I think that's when it came out. We were like 8. I don't remember. I honestly don't remember any like adult themed content. Like usually like in kid shows. Usually in kid shows they actually do like they slide in some adult content for the adults watching.
Yeah.
Christian says it came out in 1999. So almost there. Lily in chat says, are you finished with those errands?
No, exactly as I do.
I am not finished with those errands.
I don't see anything on here. I was on a think top things you might not know about. Let me see.
Christian in chat says, can we hurry up? I'm running out of time cards.
So it was, I guess this has been a question that's asked a bunch. So Google's the most reliable source next to Facebook.
And of course, Wikipedia.
And Wikipedia comes in a strong third, of course. But according to, was SpongeBob originally supposed to be for adults? Says no, it wasn't. It's always been meant for kids. The writers add some adult jokes into the mix. I don't know. I've seen this where he was green. And that's like green. The story where I got that SpongeBob should have been an adult show, and it's called like Dirty SpongeBob.
Oh, that's when he gets the suds, right?
No, this is like a pilot show, like completely separate from the SpongeBob that we know. I've seen this and I've heard of that theory. I just haven't found anything like serious that says like, hey, SpongeBob, it was an adult show and it was supposed to be like real risque.
Mm-hmm.
But,
From what I've read, the creator initially made SpongeBob to educate children on marine biology, because I think he was like a marine biologist or he worked in some form of aquarium, and he created the characters in order to help teach kids how to better understand the ocean life and stuff like that.
Okay, yeah, it was made by a marine biologist. Yeah,
yeah,
I heard that too. What else? What else? So let's read some of these things. All right, what's it? Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs?
Is this the Krusty Krab?
No, this is Patrick. This is Patrick.
But I think, I don't know how, or I don't know what, you know, they used, but SpongeBob did so well at being iconic. Pinkies dude, up, yeah. You know. So.
Stomp on your right foot. There. Don't forget it.
Then you do this. And this, and this, and this, and this, and this, and then.
I love that.
You bring it around town. Bring it around town. Dude, SpongeBob's OG.
OG.
He's a real one. He's a real one. He's just right. Like Chuck Norris.
But, you know, some things that used to freak me out sometimes where they would do the hyper-realistic cartoon. Of SpongeBob, where they do the close-ups of things like when Patrick was like a half gorilla.
And this
This one used to freak me the hell out. Like I don't know how old I was, but I turned it off when I saw this. Like they would do that with Patrick, and they would do that with Squidward. Squidward is probably the worst. I liked it though when they did Beautiful Squidward. You remember that one?
Is that the one where he's like, did he do a painting or a sculpture or something?
No, that's the one where he got bashed in the face and it made him pretty. Everybody loved
him. Oh, yeah.
Then he got bashed again and then he got back to ugly. Let's see. So I'm getting word that the donation link ain't working. So those of you who have tried to donate, here's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and add the donation link to the new donation link to the chat, Julian, if you will.
Yeah.
We'll make sure, so those of you that have been trying to donate, we appreciate it, and thanks for reaching out to me saying, hey, you tried to donate and it didn't let you. Maybe the link's a little funky. So that way you can go ahead and, you know, give to the cause. So those of you that just hopped on, we are doing a fundraiser for Miss Annabelle Hernandez, who is going through lymphoma. She's a soon-to-be addition to Julian's family. And we're just doing everything we can, especially during these kind of tough times. And we're also trying to have fun with that. I know right now the coronavirus can be a little, you know, stressful. So we're trying to have fun. We're having a good conversation. A lot of us are reliving some of the great shows that we've come up with. Let's read some of this Courage the Cowardly Dog. Yes, well, we're going to talk about that too. Weenie Hut Jr. Yeah, Weenie Hut Jr. I like the guy who put the pickles underneath his tongue. There's just so many iconic cooking episodes. But we're going to transition from shows that we love to shows that were freaking creepy. All right. So, and the link that just came up on the chat is directly to their donation page. So you don't have to go through us. Now you can go directly to them. So we appreciate all the support that you guys are doing. All right.
Mm-hmm.
So shows that are creepy now, right? So I transitioned from having to like turn off the TV because I saw this, right? Like, yeah. to legit shows that were freaking scary to me.
For me, honestly, Christian brought up Courage the Cowardly Dog. Courage the Cowardly Dog scared the crap out of me as a kid. I still watched it, but I crapped my pants after watching it.
It was always on like at freaking 1 a.m.
Yeah, like 9 up until 1. It was just like a marathon of Courage the Cowardly Dog. And all of the stuff, all of the things that went on in the middle of nowhere, right? Like all that crap. And the grandpa, he was like, ooga booga booga with the mask.
Yeah, he would scare the hell out of him. That was funny.
Oh my gosh.
That was funny. Come on, you gotta give it to him. That was freaking
hilarious. It was funny until it wasn't funny.
The one that was
started getting real.
This guy. This freaking guy.
Oh, yeah. Somebody better give that guy his plaque back.
Yeah. That was a meme for the coronavirus thing. This guy was freaking creepy. The cat who was, like, trying to eat him or give food to his spiders to eat him. this show did for sure creep me the hell out. It had a bunch of, I love Muriel, but that show was something else. Any other iconic scary moments from this show?
Dude, there's
this guy.
I don't know. Other than that guy, I don't think I can think of any.
Just the overall like mood of the show was freaking creepy. I hated it. There's this guy is a terrible, terrible scene. Ah! Yeah, that guy. He was a guy though. He ended up being nice. I remember this episode. Some episodes are grim. You're right. Some of them are like not good for kids. All right.
I want to read this from the Wikipedia page, right? Yeah. So apparently, Courage, his parents, right? I don't remember this at all, but apparently his parents were shot into outer space by a crazy veterinarian, and then Muriel found him in an alley.
That's a sad story,
right? The heck, dude.
They shot. Did they portray that in the show, or that's just something like a backstory?
I have no clue. I just saw this on the Wikipedia page, and I wanted to see if you could remember, if anybody in the chat remembers them saying anything about his parents getting shot off into space. That's what I want to know. Parents. They had an Exorcist episode. Christian says there was an Exorcist episode.
I don't see it, but hey, Chad, if you find it, there's an Exorcist episode. Oh Lord. Yeah. if you find the scene where he does get shot, his parents do get shot into space, join the.
I'm still looking. It looks like we're still live.
Yeah. Okay. Never mind. That was a false alarm. Thank God. All right. But no, we're still connected. Everything looks good.
Hey,
Lily. Thank you for donating $5. Annabelle Hernandez will surely enjoy that. We really appreciate it. All right. Muriel, that it was all in his head. I heard that it was all in his head, even Muriel. It was in the dog's head? All right, we're going to move on, all right, because I'm getting creeped out now. I'm getting the spookies. One of the shows that I freaking hated is Tales from the Crypt. You remember that one?
I never watched it myself, but yes, I do remember it.
All right, here's what we're going to do. We're gonna do the thing that I hated doing, which is watch the intro to this. Okay? Now, when I was a kid, all right, we're sitting there, it's dark. I'm eating my Cheerios, all right?
Yeah.
It's summer, mm-hmm. I'm just chilling. And I see this come on, and I instantly freaking know what this is, right? I'm like, oh geez. Oh, God. All right. And I would always have to wait and time it just right so that I can turn off the TV and turn it back on at the perfect moment, all right? And I would never do it right. I would always get caught. I would always get freaking caught during this scene. He would pop out and scare the hell out of me. I freaking hate it, man. Why did they make this show for kids?
Was it for kids? I don't think it was for kids. I think you just ended up watching it.
Imagine a little 7-year-old watching this, and I'm like, okay, I know how to time this, and I would pause it, or I would turn off the TV, mm-hmm. and I would wait. I count to 10 Mississippi and turn it back on, and then, ah, oh, God damn it, nightmares for months. Yeah, my parents used to say I'd run from seeing the Crypt Keeper. Yeah, me too. Crap my pants a couple times, but it's okay. We're here. We're
was
adults
that
now.
Show for kids? Was that supposed to be a kids show?
Yeah.
Where was it? I don't even remember. Where was it shown? I don't even know what channel was it on?
It was from the Crypt. It came out on. Was it on HBO? Yeah, it was.
That's
on
like
HBO.
For kids. You crazy.
Well, you know, I was a little kid trying to watch some HBO After Hours and freaking Tales from the Crypt would pop up. So leave me alone, all right, you know. I would watch it, and it scared the living hell out of me. The stories were cool. I liked them, but the intro was, nope, not for me. But yeah, according to Wikipedia, it came out on HBO, ran from 89 to 96 with 93 episodes. Yeah,
It was terrible.
Okay. If I ever watched that show, I must have blocked it out from my memory because I have no recollection of ever watching it.
Regressive memory, just shut it off. Like, nope, not doing that. No. All right, y'all. Anything else? You got another scary one?
Do I have another scary one? Yeah, I do.
What's that?
Animorphs. Do you remember that shit?
So that I know Animorphs from the books.
Okay, yeah. So they also had a Nickelodeon show, Animorphs.
Yeah.
And that crap scared me so bad. Because I also had the video game on the original PlayStation.
Oh, high quality HD.
High quality HD graphics, 4K, you know, all that solid stuff. But it was just so freaking creepy because they had like the aliens, right? And in the TV show, they were blue. They didn't have a mouth. They had some weird like nose thing. They had four legs and they were like Minotaur people. It was weird. And then they were fighting these blue. Yeah, that thing. Dude, that's the creepy. Like, you're telling me, like, what the heck, dude? And then,
what is that?
And then they have it has eyes on the horn parts. And then they have four eyes. I think. Yeah, I think
it's
that's
like
the
Voldemort
thing.
With horns.
and then like the villains of the show, right? Were like these slugs, and the slugs would go into your brain through your ears.
Oh yeah, ear slugs.
Dude, that's too much. I don't need all that. I don't need to see all that.
They had another one. Look at this guy.
Look at him. Look at that. You're telling me that's not scary? You're saying that's not creepy?
This is like a ape alien centaur thing. What is that?
Oh, I don't know.
It's a little cold out for this guy.
He's got fat nips. Why just like Batman.
And this was a kid show?
This was a kid's show.
This is creepy.
This was definitely a kid's show.
I don't know. Watch the show. I don't know where it was on.
I don't know if this was the bad guy or not. Does this guy have hair? Because yeah, I think the good guy was bald, and I think the bad guy had hair.
Yeah, good guys are always hairy, you know? They all got mustaches too, you know? So that's how you win the day. Dude,
this show is creepy. And I was reading the Wikipedia page for this too, because I was like, why was it creepy? Okay, but apparently if they stayed in, they could turn into animals. Huh? And the way they turn into animals, they had to pet whatever animal they wanted to turn into. And they could only turn into that animal for 2 hours. And if they were in that animal form for more than 2 hours, they were stuck there. They can't go back.
Well, then who touched this thing?
No, that thing's the alien. He's the one who gave him the powers.
Oh, you're the bad guy. Okay, I thought somebody touched this kind of thing and then freaking turned into that.
What the hell? You're like, where the heck does this thing come from?
Oh, man. Oh, I would touch a shark.
Yeah. Would you touch a shark?
Yeah, I would touch a...
To turn into a shark? Mm-hmm. Apparently, you have to fight off the animalistic, behaviors and maintain your humanistic behavior.
I wouldn't be a dog then. I'd lick my butt all day. I can't fight it. Well, I can't fight it. All right. Well, that's freaking sweet. Animorphs.
Yeah, that show is creepy.
Anybody else? What other shows out there? Let's see. Christian, you played the game. It sucked.
Yeah. Griselda said you were supposed to be asleep.
I wasn't.
You weren't supposed to.
Right. You. I'm sorry. I wasn't. I was too busy getting scared by the Crypt Keeper. All right. Goosebumps, the show, did not top the movies. I'm sorry. I mean, the books. I used to dive into those books.
I don't think I ever read the book. I just watched the show.
Goosebumps on You Afraid of the Dark, is that on par? Is that like the kids' version of Tales from the Crypt?
Yeah. Are You Afraid of the Dark? They would get around a campfire, they'd throw glitter in the fire, and then the fire would get bigger.
Come around the campfire and sing that campfire song. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. If you don't
Another
think you can sing
Meme Lord song.
All right, guys. So those were the shows, both creepy and freaking awesome. Mm-hmm. That we enjoyed. We're gonna do something a little fun. I want to end on a spooky note. All right, so we're gonna do a couple of infomercials,
that freaking sucked. Like, they failed miserably. All right. You remember, like, but wait, there's more. You know, you wake up at 2 a.m. and you're like, why the hell? Who? What are they trying to sell right now? Mm-hmm. Yeah, those things. There's a few super funny ones, and I can't believe that I never got to catch one of these live on the air. But we're going to get to view a couple of the funny ones that I found, a couple of fails that we get here. So, first one. So this guy's trying to sell some sort of crock pot thing with a lid on there, and you're not going to be able to understand. Some of you probably will. It's in a different language, and what he's trying to tell you is that this darn thing is indestructible. And he's fixing mm-hmm. to prove it with straight up facts and evidence, all right? Just like I do. So I can respect this guy. I love facts and evidence, all right? So let's listen up. Let's see what this guy has to prove, all right?
Le da alta resistencia. Sí. Esta es una tapa de vidrio, te dijimos antes. Fíjate lo que te puede pasar si se te llega a caer al piso con la hot play. Mira, la tapa de la hot play va al piso y mira. Date vuelta. Mira, vos que querías que lo hiciéramos en Carmen en vivo. ¿Quién sacaba esto si salía en vivo?
Oh, no. He felt so embarrassed. He tried explaining. He's like, no, guys, it's okay. Yeah, it's good. It's good. It's good. It's good. Oh, that's funny. That sucks. Like, I would never challenge a claim of mine live on the air like that. Like, because, you know, he didn't make that. He's on TV, and he's a guy who's supposed to promote this thing. And they're like, yeah, man, so you're going to promote this thing. It cooks real fast. It's real nice. It's real good. It's indestructible. He's like, well, hold on, what? He's like, yeah, it's indestructible. Don't worry about that one. just tell him about how well it cooks. He's like, nah, son. I'm gonna go with the indestructible thing, 100%. All right, I'm going to prove it live on the air. And he throws the freaking top and breaks. That's pretty embarrassing. another one going with that theme. All right, so someone asked for us to post a donation link. So Lily donated $5 and it popped up on our thing. So that means that my link works as well. The link is on the description, as Lily said. Use that link to go ahead and donate. We're coming up towards the end of the show. We're at five for a hopefully goal of $20. If we exceed that, that's even awesome. That's even more, you know, awesome. But if we can reach that goal, guys, like I said earlier, it's for Miss Annabelle. She's been diagnosed with lymphoma. And we're doing everything we can to get everybody through these hard times together. We're doing it together through laughs and joy. And we can help out Miss Annabelle with a couple of donations that way, too. All right. Mm-hmm.
So also the link that we posted in the chat under at Wits End, that's the direct link. So if you guys want to donate directly to the donation page, you can go ahead and follow that link. Or you can follow the link that Lily posted in the chat, and that will go. Whatever we raise here that's not through that link, the donation link, the main donation link, is going to be directly donated to them for the next 5 days. So just keep that in mind while we're going through.
All righty then. It's for a good cause, guys. Money doesn't come to us. So a lot of us are doing well right now. So let's go ahead. Keep it going. All right. So next thing. All right. Another super fail. I love this, too. I'm sure a lot of you have seen this one because this one got like meme to hell and back. But the one where the guy's trying to like prove that the ladder is super stable. Have you ever seen that
one? Oh, dude. I love this one. So this is my favorite one.
Homie says, hey, this ladder is like the bee's knees. This thing is indestructible, super sturdy. You can trust it with your life. I'm going to prove it myself. So let's see what he does.
It's a very easy situation to operate. You just push the buttons in right here on the two sides.
Yeah,
the
push
the
buttons.
And all you do is push them in, and that will release it. And what, right here. Push the button
right
in,
there.
That releases it.
I was a little confused.
And then after you let go, it locks firmly in place. So really, you're all set. And this is tough. Listen, give you an example.
Oh, he's taking it full
notch here. You know, you have to get up on the wall, high ceiling, vault
right.
to ceiling. Hey, listen, just walk right up. And I tell you, it's very safe, it's durable, and
Carol,
it's lightweight.
You're scaring me.
So really?
All right, now this is where he gets into his first debacle. All right, so he was smacking that thing, getting a little love taps. Sabrina, thank you for the donation. I know you don't get the recognition via our tracker, but thank you so much. Now, he gets a couple of love taps, a little mm-hmm. tippity taps, and it's not budging. He's feeling a little confident. He's on top of his game right now. He's
this like, is solid.
You know, he's feeling a little perky. He's got, you know, Christina right there. He's like, you know, I'm gonna prove it to her, you know? climbs up on the ladder, gives a little jingle, and that thing like gives its first little go. And it's stuck in the middle. Now, as a man, we got two options here. All right, we can either say, "Oh, I was wrong. Let me Let me backtrack a little bit, and maybe I didn't set it right. Right? Or he can go full fledged with this thing, man. He's like, nope. I'm not turning back whatsoever. Let's go ahead and see what Jim Bob does with this predicament.
Right? Now it's locked in place. Okay? So really?
So he went with, alright, no, now it's locked. Alright, man, I was, you know, before it wasn't locked. Now it's locked.
It's locked now, for sure.
And that, I don't know if you can see on the screen, but that looks perfectly like what the designers thought it should look like. Mm-hmm. Little bow in the middle. Yeah, a little bow in the middle for stability. Mm-hmm. And climb on, just monkey, like a monkey bar system, you know? Go ahead and, go ahead and climb on there. All right, let's see what happens.
You say, you have to lock it. Once you lock it, you're okay.
It's still going.
It is very safe to operate.
This is great. This is a great product.
Still going with it.
Continue to call for it.
All righty. Well, Harold, I hope you're okay.
He just got me. He was so defeated. He was like, even on the floor, back broken, spinal. He was not gonna let in, and I can't give any more respect than Gandhi himself to that man who stuck to his guns and said, no, even if my back is broken, I will lay on this floor and give props to this thing and say how safe it is, even though I got spina bifida now, and he went with it. He went full fledged. I am not backing down from this. It's safe, guys. Don't, even though I broke my back, don't stress it. It's gonna be okay.
Get yours today for only $19.99.
You think they had to drop a sale for that guy? Like,
yeah,
for after doing that, like, I drop the price. Drop the price now.
But wait, if you buy one right now in the next 2 minutes, we'll give you five more for free.
We'll give you free healthcare for one spinal treatment. Oh man, that one's, you know, he stuck to his guns though.
He gotta give it to him.
The other guy, the one before he broke the plate, he just went in straight embarrassment mode. This guy stuck to his guns, nothing but respect for the man. All right, last one. Is it the last one? One more. Yeah, let's do uno más. Okay,
one more. Let's do it.
All right, so you know, nothing safer than standing on TV and selling a couple samurai swords. And if you can notice here, we got them for a great price. You know, we got these customer appreciation deal. Our price today is going to be only $44.95 for a legitimate samurai sword taken off of a samurai master himself. Get yours now. Go ahead and give us a call at 1-800-366-4010 for your own samurai sword. Matter of fact, I'm going to prove how legitimate these samurai swords are, with no danger to myself or anybody near me. Let's do this.
1816 is the item number on this one. And the nice thing about these practice katanas. Oh!
Oh, God.
Oh, that hurt. Oh, that hurt big time. A piece of that, just the tip just got me, Odell. Oh, that got me good.
Why is the camera still running?
Because you got to show the quality of these swords. You see that? Look how nice they look. You're going to get any better.
Emergency surgery in the studio.
The show must go on. Good old Billy Bob shows up to save the day. So this guy actually had to go to the hospital and get stitches done. That blade legit came back and impaled him. But give it up to Billy Bob for stepping in the face of danger and blood. And he said,
now's my time to shine.
Billy's been waiting for this moment his whole life. Goddamn, Craig has been taking the spotlight this whole damn time.
Stupid Craig.
And now Billy's, he's like, all right, this is what I need to do. Here's my calling, my moment. And he stands in front of that darn thing. And he was like, well, guys, I've got a bit of emergency, but rest assured, customer appreciation deal $44.95 is still available to you. The camera guy didn't care either. He's just like, let me zoom in, let me get a good shot here.
Show these swords. You got to show the craftsmanship.
I gotta watch that one again. That was actually pretty funny. Let's see if I can backtrack it to before he cuts himself in the face. Uno mas. Let's give one more round of applause.
Oh, a piece of that, Tom.
Let's back it up.
Get some nice B-roll.
Oh, think about these practice katanas.
Look at this. Look how strong this. Right.
Oh, that hurt. Oh, that hurt big time. A piece of that, just the tip just got me, Odell.
Look at how strong this sword is.
Oh, that got me good. You all right? A piece of that tip just got me.
That cameraman. Just like, steady pan.
Oh, try now.
Steady pan. Grab that B-roll. He's like, shot, damn it. Getting blood everywhere.
Someone told that camera guy, no matter what happens, do not stop panning on those damn swords. I don't care if a tornado or a goddamn Jim Bob dies himself. You will continue to pan on them legitimate samurai swords.
They're made in the good U.S. of A.
USA. All
None right. of that Japanese stuff. It's good legit samurai swords.
Supposed to do that. It's like a self-destruct feature. Oh, man. I had a bunch of fun on this show. How about you guys? Drop some likes if you had some fun. Give some shares. Hit me them follows. Guys, I don't know where we're at right now on follows because our follow thing, we hit it. So, yeah. Sorry, I think I can pop it up real quick. No, that's not accurate. That's not accurate because it hasn't been tracking. All right. We're really close to our follower goal in the next video. We'll go ahead and have the follower goal up. Guys, you can continue to hit that link up, whether it's my link or the original link, to give those donations to Ms. Hernandez as she goes, you know, she battles through this lymphoma. Rest assured, we got her back. Thank you, Griselda, for the like. And we'll continue to do so, okay? Once you're part of this family, you know, we got each other's back, all right? We're going to end the show here, right? Julian, got anything else to add?
Yeah, you know what? Like, hey, guys, all right, real talk, though. Okay,
let's get real.
This link is going to be up for the next 5 days. So any donations that you guys are able to make, if you just share this video for the next 5 days, all the money that is raised through our video, through that link, the direct link, whatever, is going to go straight directly to Annabelle. And it's going to help her with her medical bills and all that stuff. And just keep that in mind, guys. So share with all your friends. Make sure we're getting the word out there. Let's try to help out as much as we can, especially with all this Corona stuff going on. I know times are hard. So if you got a dollar, if you got 10 cents, 20 cents, whatever, anything, we appreciate it. We thank you. And I hope you guys enjoy the show.
Right on. All right. So we always end the show with a random internet find. If you are watching live on Facebook, this is exclusive for you. So if you're on YouTube watching this video now, you're going to get cut out right about now. So if you want to be a part of the live show and watch our awesome, we showed that awesome Star Wars, that fan film. That one was freaking sweet.
It was pretty sweet.
We had that song that got mixed by the Tropic Thunder sounds.
Oh, dude, that was so good.
So without further ado, if you're on YouTube, this is where the show will end for you. We'll catch you on the next one. If you're on YouTube, go ahead and follow the show. Give us a subscribe. Give us a like on this video. Give us a dislike if you don't like it. That helps us, you know, figure out what the heck we should be doing. And drop some comments on all the stuff like that. Because even on the last video where we talked about the Mandela Effect, we got some new comments from a guy from Europe. And he started talking about all this cool stuff. And we were chatting back and forth. And it was freaking sweet. And we loved it. So that's the kind of stuff, if you're watching this after the fact, continue. We're still a part of this. So, YouTubers, see ya.